गुड आफ्टरनून, यस, सो एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर साइड? सिलेबस कवर कंप्लीटेड, यस यस यस, गुड आफ्टरनून. एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर साइड? एनी न्यूमेरिकल, एनी रीजनिंग क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर सिलेबस? विवेक, एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर साइड? You write it your numerical question and reasoning question, because I have one question. What is the question? What is the question? Work energy power. A ball is dropped from a top of a building while another ball is thrown horizontally at the same instant. Which ball will strike the ground first, the ground, and why? This question I have already seen in your e-portal, but one question is here. You see here, a ball is dropped from a height. Dropped from a height, suppose this, and another ball. Check. Another ball, you throw the horizontal. Horizontal means, what is the meaning of horizontal? This, not that. Mute your mic, okay. Horizontal direction, that means this. This is the projectile. Okay. This means the one kinds of projectile motion, and this is the vertical motion. So it is not in your syllabus, please. This projectile motion is not in your syllabus. So when you will come in class 11, that time you see the projectile motion and what will be its formula and what will be its derivation. So you left it. Okay, I will give your answer through the e-portal. Wait, question is clear, but through your e-portal, the question is not clear. So now question is clear. Your question is this, you check it. My dear student, you check it. One ball is dropped, means it follows the vertical motion. Another ball is motion horizontal. Horizontal means this direction. Okay. I think from here, this is not, it is not the path, path is there. So if you just move this, try to move this object in along this direction, means horizontal, means parallel to it, the locus of this object is this. This is called the projectile motion. So I will give the answer through the e-portal, you check it. Okay, this is the projectile motion, it is not in your syllabus. If the distance between two masses is increased by a factor of 5, by what factor would the mass of one of them have to be altered to maintain the same gravitational force? Would this can be increase or decrease of the mass? Again, if the distance between the two masses is increased by a factor of 5, if the distance between the two masses is increased by a factor of 5, by what factor would the mass of one of them have to be altered to maintain the same gravitational force? Oh, hold on. Okay. F equal to gmm by r square. You know it, the gravitational force. F equal to gmm by r square. F equal to gmm by r square. You know it. If the distance between the two masses is increased by a factor 5, okay? Distance. That means if you consider this is the r1, it will be increased 5. When you consider it the R2, 5 of R1. Increased by a factor of 5. By what factor would the mass of one of them have to be altered to maintain the same gravitational force? So, if you put it here in place of R1, okay, so in place of R1, what will be its value? So, both are F1 equal to F2. So, F2 equal to G, suppose you consider it, both are equal. Would the mass of one of them have to be altered? M1 and M2. M1 and M2. That is capital M1 and M, that time is equal to the R2 square. If you consider this is the R1 square. Question is this, F1 equal to F2. F1 equal to F2. So, you check here, the GG cancel, okay, R1 cancel, R2 equal to 5 of R1. So, in place of R1, you write here, G capital M, this is 1 and 2, same thing, M1 and M2, my dear student, you know it, M by 5 R1 square. So, if both are equal, that time you see, those value must be 25, that means GG cancel, M and M, and that is the R1 equal to M and M dash 25 R1 square. So, this cancel. So, relations are here. So, first time M and small m equal to 1 by 25 M dash and M dash. So, it will be 1 by 25. The ball will move slightly to the horizontal direction and then it will be fall. Yes. My dear student, question is clear. So, next I will try to give the answer through the e-portal because it is not in your syllabus. Okay? Not in your syllabus. The diagram is this. You check it. Again, I will try to draw it. The diagram is this. The object is here on top of a tower. Object is dropped from the top of a tower, so direction is this, first one. Second one, you throw the ball horizontally, means this. Okay, so you check it, the two diagrams are there. This is the projectile motion. So, this projectile motion is not in your syllabus. So, I will give the answer through the e-portal next day. First time, the question is not clear. First time, it was not clear. Now, it is clear. So, Vivek, next I will try to complete, through the e-portal. Next question. Yes, but increase or decrease? Oh, this is 1 by 25. You check here. So, this relation and that relation, the next time 1 by 25, you check here, first time M and M dash equal to 1 by 25 M dash and M dash. So, you check here the 1 by 25 times of that, or 25 times for the first masses. Okay, 25 into mm equal to m dash into m dash. Yes, but sir, that means it would be 25 times, but increase or decrease? You check it. You check it here. Increase or decrease? You check here. This is the first time. You consider it. That value is the x and 1 by 25 y. So it will increase or decrease? Y equal to 25 x. So 25 times from the first. So it will be increased. Okay? Okay? Next question. Today is the total revise work power energy. This question from the gravitational force means gravitational chapter, but you try to question from your work energy power. Any question? Work energy power. No questions from your side. Repeat the energy portion. Beta, this is not the question. Repeat the energy question. You come through your chat, what is your requirement? Only energy portion means energy, total energy is the potential energy. And the kinetic energy. Amen. X goes to the top of a building by a vertical spring staircase. Another man, Y of the same mass goes to the top of the same building by a standing ladder. Okay, vertical stair, standing ladder. Which of the two does more work against gravity and why? Both are same. Because work done equal to change in kinetic energy, that means the potential energy, both are changed, both are same. That means m into g into h. You start from here, you raise the portion here, this. You will follow this route, you will follow that route, you will follow from this to that route as you wish. But you are here. You count it to what will be the energy at that point. The height from the ground is h. The object is at rest. So only energy is there, potential energy. What will be its value? The value will be m into g into h. So the work done change into the potential or the kinetic energy. So potential energy. So that value will be m into g into h. So it does not depend on the direction of the path. It only depends on the height from the ground. Okay. So the energy, ability doing some work. I also try to throw this object. Due to this motion, it doing some work. That work is kinetic energy change into the work done. Okay. If you put it the object at a particular height, object try to doing some work. That means if you fall from this height, you see the energy is transferred from one to another. So that means the potential energy, kinetic energy, all the mechanical energy. But rest of the energy, you know it, so many energies are there. So those are correlated. Those are change their form one to another, but no loss of energy, no create of energy. Okay. So potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy means if you put it object at a height from the surface, that means change its position. Due to this change in position, it ability doing some work, that means create some work, that form change into the energy, that energy is the potential energy. And that value will be, potential energy will be m into g into h. But kinetic energy due to the motion of this object, it will create some work. That value will be kinetic energy due to its motion, the value will be half m v square minus u square. How can we derive it? This is the question. How can we derive it? What is the kinetic energy? You see, suppose an object moving with a velocity u. You apply the force on this object along the direction of motion. Due to this force, its velocity will be v. At that time, the uniform acceleration is a, and it covers a distance, that value is equal to s. So, my dear student, you know it. From those data, you can write it v square equal to u square plus 2a into s. V square equal to u square plus 2a into s. So, 2a into s equal to v square minus u square. S equal to v square minus u square by 2a. Okay. So what will be its work done? Work done change into the kinetic energy. Work done is form a kinetic energy. That means kinetic energy equal to work done f into s. F means m into a into s. What will the value of s you put here? You put here m into a into s means v square minus u square by 2a. A cancel. So you write it half into m into v square minus u square. This is the derivation for the kinetic energy. So my dear student, you check it. It also called the work done. So work done is a change in kinetic energy. Wait, one by one. Two girls, each of weight 400 Newton, climb up a rope through a height of 8 meter. Okay? We name one of the girl A, other is B. Girl A takes 20 seconds while B takes 50 seconds to accomplish the task. What is the power? Oh, power. You find out the power. You first find out the potential energy. Okay. Potential energy form of work done. Work done by time, that is equal to power. So, my dear student, a very easy question. You check it. So, check it. Potential energy. What will be the potential energy first for the first girl? A, 400 newton, 8 meter height. This is the potential energy, 400 newton into 8 meter. That is the joule. Okay. So potential energy, power for the girl A. What will be the power? Na? Power for the first girl, 400 into 8 by how many times for the first girl to take to raise the top of it? A takes time 20 second, joule per second, that is equal to what? 20 second, joule by second, 20, yes, at 1860 watt. Okay. For the second girl, potential energy for the second girl B, 400 into 8 meter, 400 into 8 meter, that is equal to joule. Okay. And time takes for 50 second. So power for the second girl, 400 into 8 by 50. Watt by second means, joule by second means what? At 64 watt. Okay. Clear. Next is, a bullet of mass 50 grams has a speed of 400 meter per second. What is the kinetic energy? Very, very easy question. You try to disturb your teacher. You are seeing everything and you are trying to disturb your teacher. So you see here the mass of the bullet is 50 gram. So you change it, the unit, gram and meter per second. So you change it, the gram into the kilogram, 50 by 1000 kg. And V equal to 40 meter per second. Okay, V equal to 400. Oh, sorry. 400 meter per second. Okay, what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy equal to half mv square. So that value will be half into 15 by, sir, you wait here please. Okay. 400, yes. You check it. If the bullet strike a thick target and is brought to the rest in 2 centimeters, calculate the average net force acting on the bullet. 2 centimeters. Okay. Brought to rest. What happened to the kinetic energy originally in the bullet? The kinetic energy change into the heat energy and the sound energy. So this is the kinetic energy, 1200 joule. Next part, it will be rest after the 2 centimeter, S equal to 2 centimeter. 2 centimeter, that means 0.02 meter. Okay. So you know it, V equal to zero rest. So, V square equal to U square plus 2S, V equal to 0 square, U equal to 400 square plus 2 into A into S equal to 0.02. 400 into this. Buddha dekhaya chhe. Just wait, one second, wait. Okay, so you calculate it, the value of A, you calculate it. The first, okay. Middle one, yes. Middle numerical, yes. Okay, so you calculate the value of A and then you find out the value of F equal to M into A. You put it and you calculate it. Okay, my dear student. The value of A is here and the value of force equal to M into A. The value of M is given in your question paper. 15 gram. You write it 15 by 1000 kilogram. That into meter per second square. That is the unit of force. That is the unit is Newton. You calculate it. Next numerical. The work done by a force acting obliquely is given by the formula W equal to F cos theta into S. Very good. What will happen to the work done if the angle theta between the direction of the force and the motion of the body is increased gradually? Oh, my dear student, you know it. What is the value of cos theta if theta is increased? You know it. You check here, cos 0 degree equal to 1, cos 30 degree equal to root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree equal to 1 by root 2, cos 60 degree equal to half, cos 90 equal to 0. So, my dear student, you note it and you find out it. If the angle increase, then you start from here, 0 to this, this to that, that to that, again that to that. So what happened? You try to complete it. Angle between the direction of the force and the motion of the object increase gradually. Will it increase or decrease or remain same? You check here, will it decrease? You check here, it will be decrease. Okay. Yes. Yes. So now it is okay. Coming. Yes. Okay. Next, any question? Any question? Any question? present question, if the momentum of a body is increased by 10%, then find the increase in the kinetic energy. You know the relation, you calculate it. This is the question for 3 or 4 level. You only know this formula. P equal to under root of 2m into E. If the momentum is 2%, what will be the kinetic energy? You calculate it. My dear student, you try to complete it. Does he have do the Kepler's law? Kepler's law, you only try to remember it. But derivation and no numericals, no explanation in your syllabus. You only remember it, the Kepler's law of planetary motion. Okay. So, my dear student, see you again next day. Thank you. Thank you, my dear student. Any question from your side? Gravitation chapter. Next I will try to revise your gravitational chapter. Okay? Okay, my dear student. Thank you. Thank you, my dear.